Hello students, today we come to the concluding part, that is part 4 of our video lesson on simple equations. So in the beginning we have seen the concept, how it comes, and there are three different ways, and basically here what we are using is a transposing method of transposing. If you see, this is called transposition method. Transposition means that we shift to the other side of the equal to sign. Okay, so here I have done easier sums. Now we will do little difficult sums. So the very first sum I take is from the exercise 12.2. Okay, see one thing, if you see different books, children, most of the question only values change. The basic thing is same. And one more thing before I start, this is little easy in class 6 because you are doing it for the first time. But when you go to 8, you will have little harder simple equation. Then we'll start in 9 simultaneous equation, quadratic equation. Class 10 we go to cubic equation. Actually it's called remainder and factor theorem in ICSC. If you want to see, all those videos are there for class 10. Almost most of the syllabus except one or two chapters, class 10 the video is there for ICSC. Now so basic idea of equation remains same. So here what we see, first we open the bracket, 9 into y is 9y, 9 ones are 9, you need to multiply, children. 3 I could have taken that side now, so you could take later also, there is nothing wrong in taking now also. So since here there are two numbers, we do it, 6, 9y. So we transpose, you can write in bracket, transposing 6, transpose 6 to RHS, like you will see in some book somewhere written what we have done. Okay, here you can write, we open the bracket, transpose 6 to RHS. So this I have told you once more, this is called the right hand side, this is called the left hand side. So therefore, when y is alone, here you could have one more step, children. You first write 45, but I skip one step and I divide by 9. 9 goes down. 9 5s are 45. Therefore, y is 5. Okay. So here if you substitute, we call it check or verify. You put 5 here on the left hand side to see whether answer is right or not. 5 plus 1 6. 9 6 are 54. Minus 3 is 51, you will get. I think if my memory is right, in my previous video, I think I have done this sum. Okay, anyway, there's no problem in revising, repeating. One of my maths professor used to say something very important, I remember. You need practice, as I have told you 100 times. That, see, this is not a TV serial or a movie. You need, this is a learning thing. So what that professor used to tell, that any sum, easy hard, you do 5 times. You will say, why? Because many children, they do once. See, first time you learn, second time you get more confidence. Okay, third time, your time taken will be less. So see here, when you do a number of times, suppose I did it in the second time, for the second time, you will take lesser time. What are the advantage of doing more number of time? I'll tell you a few sum in higher classes. First time you take 5 minutes. Then if you do fourth and fifth time, you will take 1 minute. You will be faster, more accurate, and chances of making silly mistakes will be very less. So one chapter, children, remember, I have told you that you learn tables, few cardinal rules, do maths, don't see, pause the video, I tell, write. Another thing is do a number of times. Now I taught today, you do. Weekend you get, holidays you get, you revise. In between you revise. So many times you sleep till the exam. and before that you don't know how to handle. So if you are practicing throughout, it is very easy to understand anything. So don't leave it till the final exam. Okay, so here we go. So that was my idea. So if I have done once more, no problem. So I'll do one more sum before I tell you to pause the video and copy. And if you cannot match, if you have any problem, I go quite slowly, boys. You are in class 6. So if you have any problem, first you understand. Copying come next. Next. 2C. So first you understand, pause the video, then you copy, you can take a screenshot. There are various ways. So 2x minus 7 is 5 minus x. So double, once equal to sign is there, children, don't put equal to sign again. Remember, either or, I was telling you my father used to write or. Okay, then we see implies anyone. Okay, nowadays we use implies sign. So here 2x, x will come to the LHS with plus sign and 7 will go with plus sign. Minus becomes plus this side of the bridge, that is equal to, and minus that side becomes plus. So what we get, children, is this side we get 3x and this side 12. So here I told you there is a hidden into sign, very small you can put. So multiplication becomes division. So 3 grows down, we get x as 4. So finally, to make the work of your teacher easy when you give exam, write the answer at the end so that generally when we correct, we go back, you go like this, okay, top to bottom. When we correct, we go from bottom to up. Yes, you got 4, then we see almost you got 12, something like this. Okay, practically we scan the whole thing like a scanner. Then we know you are right. So always write the answer neatly, cleanly at the end. Okay, now let us verify or what we call check. Put x is equal to 4. Okay. One of my professor, K.K. Mitro in St. Xavier's Ranchi, used to bring colored chalks. If possible, I'll bring, and he used to like here verification. I could have used colored chalks, children. So put x is equal to 4 on the left hand side, children. This is called checking or verifying. X is equal to 4 and I subtract. So see, 4 to the 8, this side. 8 minus 7 is 1. Let us see RHS. Okay, 5 minus 4. X is 4. This value I put here. So here 4, 8 minus 7 is 1. This side I get 1. 8 minus 7 is 1. So here 5 minus 4 also I get 1. So my left side is equal to right side. That means our answer is right. So kindly pause the video and copy. Then we will do few more sums. Okay, we move on to question 3C. This looks a big question. Like this you will have in class 8. This is where you will start your simple equation. So this is a big sum. I'll do one sum in one go. Okay, so whenever we copy question, children, we need to check it again. Yesterday in my video I was telling you, don't copy wrong question. Multiply with sign. Minus 7 4s are 28. 7 3s are 21. Into x is x. 7 4s are 28. 5. See, this is very tricky. 5 2s are 10x. Minus minus becomes plus. 5 3s are 15. Okay. Minus 10x. Very important thing, boys. Minus minus plus. Second thing, x with x we will do 21x. So we will put together x and number we will put together. Minus 28 plus 15. So what I have done? Unknown with unknown. Okay, and if you do, see, there are many videos I have made before for class 6 and 7, you see where I have explained, subtract the smaller from the larger and put the sign of the larger. So if you have any problem in solving this, my class 6 videos are there in board mass or number there. You will see I have made specially for that. So minus, what is the rule? Minus is bigger, plus is smaller. Subtract the smaller from the larger. So 15, if you subtract from 28, you get 13. Put the sign of the larger, because if this is plus, this is minus, it will be plus 13. So 11x is 13 goes side, goes to that side. You can write transposing minus 13 to the other side, we get plus 13. And something very nice comes, you will get such a value, children in class 6, that these two will cancel each other. Generally, there is no cardinal rule that it has to cancel and you may not get fraction. You will get fraction, boys. So 11x, 22. So this is a multiple of this if you have done LCM. Generally, not always. Okay, so we got x is equal to. Let us check or verify something very important. Okay, I call it verify. So LHS, only on the left hand side. Forget this, don't write 9. I should get 9 over here. So 7. Okay, 2 I am writing here, so that I have space here. Okay, 7. Let me draw a line. 7, 3 into 2. In place of x, children, we write 2. 3 into 2 minus 4. Minus 5, 2 into 2 minus 3. Let us see what we get. This is like simplify, no? Board mass rule we were doing. You remember in arithmetic we had 7 into, first do bracket, 2 minus 5 into 1. So we get 14 minus 5, which is 9, which is my RHS. This is the way we do, children. And I remember my teacher, okay, we used to write finally one last line, hence verified. Last line I remember, hence verified means left side is 9, my answer is correct. So one thing I told you before, if your question you have copied correctly and you get the answer and you verify, means you are right. But if you copy a wrong question, children, you will get right answer, but teacher may not give you mark in exam. So what is very important thing I am teaching you? Whenever you copy a question, be it your classwork, homework, especially in exam, see and check twice that you have copied the question properly. Otherwise, all your effort will go in vain. So kindly pause the video and copy. So let us do few more questions before we end this class and this video. So this is a small question, children, if you see. So into multiplication becomes division. So 12 fours are 48. X is 4, if you verify, 4, 12 fours are 48. Okay, if you see number G, X minus 8 is 3. So 8 will go there. We'll get X as 11. So right implies these things are important. Therefore, in the last step we put. Okay, so X is 11, 11 minus 8 is 3. So some easier question we had. Okay, if I see H, here we see division becomes multiplication. Very good question. X 3 goes up. Division becomes multiplication. So we get X as 12. If you verify, children, 12 divided by 3, forget right side, 12 by 3 is 4. Okay. Then one question I will do. Two questions before I end this video. So 5 part A, I see X minus 2 minus. So this is like a fraction, children. Here one is hidden. Okay, we'll solve this and one more question I'll do, 5D, and we'll end the video for today. So what we do here, children, we take LCM 3, see nicely. This is another important thing. Last question was big, and this you see, 2 3s are 6. LCM we have learned, lot of videos are there in class in 6 and 7. 2 goes 3 times, so x will be multiplied with 3. Okay, 2 goes 3 times minus, so like that crisscross, because this 6 is prime to 2 and 3, these two numbers are prime to each other. 3 goes 2 times, so this will be multiplied with 2. Once more, 2 goes 3 times, so this will be multiplied with 3, and 3 goes 2 times with 6, so this will be multiplied by 2. Now since we have common denominator, this can go up. You cannot take this 2 or 3 up there. First we have to have a common denominator. This I have told you in my earlier video also. So this I'll get 4 into 6. So here I get x is 24. Therefore x is 24. So if you verify 24 by 2 is 12 minus 24 by 3 is 8. So 12 minus 8 you will get 4. Once more. You have to improve your mental maths. 12 or 24 you put here, you will get 12, 24 by 2. 24 by 3 you will get 8. So my left side is 4, right side is also 4. So one last question before I end the class and end this chapter called Simple Equations for Class 6. Okay, so 5D children, if you see, this is x by 4. Plus 4 x by 5 plus 6. Okay, so let us solve this, and try to get the correct answer. Now you see x by 4 is bigger, 1/4 is bigger than 1/5, because you see my previous video, this was bigger than this, so I transpose it to the other side. But x by 4, when denominator is small, the fraction is bigger. So remember this, x by 4 or 1 by 4 is greater than 1 by 5. Okay. So it is 1 by 5 is less than 1 by 4, and this 4 you take to the other side. So we get 6 minus 4 is 2, here we take LCM children. 4 and 5, LCM is 20, 4 goes 5 times, 5 goes 4 times. Okay, now I can take 20 to the other side. So here I get x, 20 goes there, so x is 40. That is the answer, therefore x is 40, right, nicely. Let us verify. If you want to verify LHS and RHS, 40 by 4 plus 4. Okay, this is my left hand side, and what is my right hand side, we will see. Don't put them equal to. RHS is x by 5 plus 6, so x is my 40, and here also I have put x is equal to 40. So 40 by 5 plus 6, I get 5 8s are 40. 8 plus 6 is 14 I get. Let us see this side. 10 it cancels. 4 10s are 40. 10 plus 4 is 14. Both side is 14. So, kindly pause the video and try to understand the verification also, that both side will be 14. That means my answer. So here generally I was telling you, I learned from hence proved. That we have proved that we have got the right answer. So with this video children, we come to the end of simple equation. So kindly practice, do solved and unsolved example. Thank you children for watching this session of 4 videos on simple equation class 6.